Hi, this is Priyanka Mishra. Today I am going to present on 360 degree performance appraisal. 360 degree performance appraisal is also known as multi-source feedback. As the name itself reflects that the information is taken or the source is the different people, like from the upper level to the lower level, so it involves each and every person of the organization. When the person is being assessed with the peers, it forms 90 degree, and when the survey goes for the direct report, it forms 180 degree, and when the internal customers, it's taken 270 degree, and finally it completes with the supervisors and making it as a 360 degree. So it involves each and every person of the organization, whoever is there. Next is the cycle of performance appraisal. Most of the organization or every organization, they used to follow this cycle as per their objective and what they have to achieve. Based on that, planning is made accordingly based on their performance, that what it should be improvised and what they should eliminate from their policies. So planning is made based on that. There are some committee members or the departments who takes care of monitoring the planning, that whatever they plan, it's as per the goal of the organization or not. And after that, the approval of that planning, developing is done, and then rating, and then based on the rating, the person is rewarded accordingly. So the 360 degree performance is one of the modern method and one of the popular method of assessing the individuals, especially the employees, and it can be assessed in each and every field. So what are the uses of 360 degree feedback? First is self-development and individual counseling. So whenever the company is having their earlier what was happening in traditional methods, supervisors, they used to give feedback about their employee, and it was the only one way, and it may be biased, it can be a biased one. So they were unhappy for that, but due to this method, when the feedback is taken from each and every member, so it improves their self-development and individual counseling, because after the feedback is taken, they are counseled for that what are the points they should improve, points of improvement, and what they should eliminate from their performance appraisal. And then organized training and development. It brings the 360 feedback, it is organized as the organized training and development, that what are the training and development are necessary for the employees so that they can move into their future, and what are the lacuna they are facing or whatever the weakness they are facing in the working places and all. So they will be providing training and development for that employee, and it will be improvising their future goal. Next is improve team building. So it helps the organization to improve their team building things, and this will be beneficial to the organization. Every organization, in everywhere, employees, something is going into their mind, but due to this, it's a pure clarify that what is there and what is right, what is wrong. So it helps them to improvise their team building things. Then performance management. It helps the performance management to act accordingly as per their evaluation and how to give the importance to that employee and how they can move into their future. Next is strategic or organization development. So it helps them to make a strategic planning and organization to develop in such a manner so that they can move into the future. Then determinant of remuneration. Whenever the employee is rated as very high, so it to motivate them, they used to give the remuneration, that what should be their remuneration, so that they will be motivated and they will be working hard, and it will be in favor of the organization. Now what are the key steps to effectively implement 360 degree appraisal? First of all, top management communication goal and need of 360 degree appraisal is very necessary. Whenever the things are coming into the picture, top management communication is one of the most important thing is playing a major role, because 360 degree is not a one shot game. It involves each and every person. So if the top management level, they will be cooperating and supporting the every level, it will be beneficial for the organization. So first step is top management communication goal and need for 360 degree performance appraisal, they should understand. And then a team of employees and managers should participate in the development of appraisal criteria and process. Every employee and the manager, it's necessary that they should participate in the criteria and process, whatever it is decided for this method. Then train employees or giving and receiving constructive feedback. If the training is not, proper training is not given to the employees, obviously it will be impacting a lot to them in a very bad way, and this will be harmful for the organization. So the employees should be trained properly and they should be receiving and giving constructive feedback, not useless things, and useful things, it will make them to move forward. Then instruct employees on the nature of the 360 degree instrument and process. Whenever this method is taking place, so employees, it should, the instruction should be given to them properly, and what's the nature of 360 degree instrument. As every organization, they are having their own way of and own criteria or own way of evaluation for the things. So they should instruct that how they should be used. Then pilot test the appraisal first in one part of the company. Whenever any thing is decided that this criteria, it should come into the picture. So it should be pilot test should be done, so that it will be determining that whether it is useful or what's the level of that, or it's not impacting a lot. Then last is continually reinforce the goals of the 360 degree performance appraisal and be ready to change the process whenever needed. This is one of the necessary things, like whenever the goals, as per the goals, the 360 degree performance appraisal, it should be continuously, it should be reinforced, and we should be ready to change the process whenever it's needed for the welfare of the organization. So finally, I conclude with that 360 degree performance appraisal is playing a major role for the organization, and every organization is accepting day by day, as they don't have knowledge regarding this, but most of the organization, they are accepting it as it is a modern method and one of the very useful method to improvise their skills and knowledge in the for the long run. That's all. Thank you.